This is an example of biaxial deformation on thin-walled pressure vessels. So if you review your equations on longitudinal and tangential stress for thin-walled pressure vessels. So these are the data given. We have the dimension of this pipe. This is actually a welded steel cylindrical drum. So it's a welded steel cylindrical drum with a Poisson's ratio of 0.3. Then you have the modulus of elasticity, which is equal to 200 gigapascals, or that's times 10 to the 3 megapascals. And then you have the internal pressure of 1.5 megapascals. So we just take note of the units. Now you have millimeters here, and then you have the diameters in meters. So you need to convert this later. And then we're asked to find the change in diameter. So because of the pressure present in the drum, we are anticipating a change in diameter from the original diameter of 1.20. So solution. So we are actually looking for the change in diameter, which we could get from, of course, strain, because we know that strain is just deformation divided by L, or this is the change in length over the original length. Now, that's the original concept of strain, or in this case, we can say that since the diameter is in the x direction, we can say that stress a strain along the x direction is just equal to change in diameter over the original diameter. Since from this is the change in length divided by the original length. In this case, we have the change in diameter divided by the original diameter. Now, so this is given, this is what is asked, and this is also unknown. So we will get this to get this. So since it's a biaxial deformation, and then we are concerned with the change in along the x direction, we have strain x so is equal to 1 over e times stress x minus v stress y, and we can calculate both of these using, again, as I've said earlier, your longitudinal and tangential stresses. So x is your tangential because it's along this direction, and y is your longitudinal stress. So stress y equals longitudinal stress, which is equal to PD over 4T. So you have the 1.5 newton per mm square. You have the D, or diameter, which is 1.2 meters, or that's 1200 millimeters. Notice that I converted the 1.2 meters to 1200 millimeters. And then you have 4 times thickness, which is 10 mm. You will have stress Y equals, so let's evaluate this. You have 1.5 times 1200 divided by 4 times 10. It's 45 megapascals. 4 millimeters cancel, we have megapascals. Your stress Y, or stress X, which is your tangential, we know that tangential is just twice your longitudinal stress. So you have 90 megapascals. If you want to double check, that's just PD over 2T. So that's 1.5 times 1200 divided by 2 times 10. So let's just input this. You have 1.5 times 1200 divided by 20. That's 90. 90 megapascals. Now you have stress X and stress Y. You can now calculate for the strain along the X direction. 1 divided by, that's 200 times 10 to the 3 megapascals times your stress x, which is 90 megapascals minus v, which is 0.3. then you have your stress y, which is 45 megapascals. This is a bracket. We have strain, which is equal to, we have 90 minus 0.3 times 45 divided by 200 times 10 to the 3. That's 3.825 times 10 to the negative 4. And then we'll compute for the delta D. It's just delta D is just equal to times D. You will have 3.825 times 10 to the negative 4 times diameter, which is 1200 mm. Your delta D, or change in diameter, is just equal to 0.459 mm. So therefore, it's a positive change in diameter. Your drum has expanded due to the presence of this 1.5 megapascal internal pressure. So that's it. I hope you, again, just a review. This one, the longitudinal stress and the tangential stress. So again, tangential is just twice your longitudinal stress. And then since we're concerned with the diameter, it's in the x direction or x axis. That's why we look for the strain along the x direction. So that's it.